hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Where's, hey, Chucks, where my, in the studio.
Neck again.
We got hats
playing around. Hey, I can sing a little bit, but yeah, you know what I'm saying? We walking over here and stuff, and we just, like, we see a couple people walking across the street or whatever. So, all I see is the man Avery was, you know, playing around, being a jokester that he is. Someone took it the wrong way. Oh, and you never see action at Heidelberg's campus, so I just looked over and seen everybody looking angry and upset from across the street. And my first thought was not to stop the action, but to bust out my camera. That was my first, that was my first thought. So first thing I did, I'm like, man, I'm about to pull my camera out so I can't miss this action if something go down. You know what I'm saying? Everybody's playing the, chill out, don't let it happen, bro. I'm on the, wow, I need to get all this in my camera. I got all 64 gigs on this phone, and I'm going to use it for something.
I was just confused, man, because it was like, that's my little homie. So it was like, I was like, hey, bro, you don't know him. So like, I was just kind of confused. I'm like, why so serious, bro? Like, it ain't even that serious. I don't care. I mean, you might have a nice little girl or whatever. I mean, but she ain't worth all that.
Yeah, he don't really want to know about her, man.
At all.
It was crazy. Wow. Everybody's on the trigger.
Oh, no.
Here goes Janessa coming in late again, as usual.
Yeah. Not as usual.
As usual.
I didn't get my class at 1 a.m. I even wore my shirt to
class. Get out of here, man.
The math instructor, I came here louder than Ron and Nandy.
Wow. You're going crazy,
Jesus.
Dude, grab a chair and sit down. You're all going crazy.
Yo.
But,
Randy took my seat.
She's late.
That's
my seat.
Hey, I want you to start texting Kendall from now on. You see I'm all stuck in here, you always want me to come get you.
Don't text
him. I know.
He right by the door.
He's the one that always escapes anyways.
Everybody's on my back.
He make eye contact with you every time you walk up, and he just act like
he see make eye contact.
He look through the window every time and be like,
wow.
Nah, cuz.
Yeah. Everybody's right on my back. But, see, we about to come on and drop some of this new music that we got for y'all.
He said,
you know what I'm saying?
Something's not,
I wouldn't say it's all new music, but it's new for us and new to y'all. So, it'll be new music. You know, I might drop a couple videos on Snapchat as dancing, because we've been in here turned up all day. It's about this weather, you know what I'm saying? That got us all happy. You know, we got Easter break coming up.
It ain't cold no more.
We got Easter break coming up.
My coach put an April Fool's joke on us today. He got us good.
Yeah, by April Fool's.
He was all like, you guys are about to do 100 burpees. And he was like, do you really think I was that big of a, that would have you, I mean, yeah, you had us do it before, so why would it be different?
Wow.
And he's like, no, you only do 20.
Wow. Played around with you guys.
He did. He got us good.
Yeah, so, but, you know, another thing, if y'all got some April Fool's stories that happened to y'all today or in the past, call in and let us know about it. We want to hear about some things that happened. If we got some, we're going to share them with y'all and let y'all know how April Fool's has gone in the past for us. And you know what I'm saying? We just want to see what's going on.
I ain't got nobody today, man. Like, I've been chilling. Like, I ain't
dude, Ida got someone today. That was funny.
Well, she was like, you ain't got no swipes.
Ooh.
Yeah, no,
hit you with the move.
You know, we might hit y'all with a couple April Fool's stories. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna give y'all numbers so y'all call in.
Yeah, we might be able
to do something else.
419-448-2200.
Yeah, my mom's sorry because I told her about the Easter break. I'm about to be at the house. No, it's only we just get a day off then the weekend, so it's not nothing for real.
Well deserved.
Yeah, we earned it.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. It was silly, but you know, we are chilling around now. We've been doing dog soldiers. Everybody's the whole football team's been working hard lately.
Volleyball, you know still working hard like usual.
You know what I'm saying? So, shout out to Berg Football.
Dog soldiers.
Drop some music. Y'all have been. They've been scared to do it because it's so controversial, and I just don't care. So, basically, and over this last week, especially, I've been hearing a lot of stuff that's been pertaining to males and females fighting each other. And what happened was, you know what I'm saying, we thought about this topic a while ago, but, you know, it surprised this week though, like on some crazy to the point where I'm like, we gotta talk about it now. You know what I'm saying? We wanna know, like, you know what I'm asking y'all, we come to the topic on some, is it ever a right time to hit a female? Would you hit a female or would you not hit a female being a man? And if you were a girl, would you hit a male? You know what I'm saying? Not on some, oh, he's trying to kill me type stuff. But like, you know what I'm saying? Like, let's say you're just angry and you're going to hit that man. Do you expect him to hit you back or do you not? Like, what goes through your head before you make that decision as a female and as a guy?
No, it ain't no, I'm trying to kill him. It's like, I want to fight.
No, yeah, I'm just saying.
Like anger. I'm saying,
like, if you're like mad type, do you hit a guy? Not on some self defense. Oh, I think he's trying to run you type stuff.
And then also, everybody's on the side. And then on the, like, you know, a part of that is like making it clear with, you know, like, the, like, because I mean, this is all considered domestic violence. Yeah, domestic violence. So, like, are you one of those dudes who just believes, like, you hit your girl because the wind blow? Like,
that's crazy.
Like,
bro.
That's what I'm saying. So it's
that's crazy. That's, there are people out there like that.
Yeah, it is.
Wow.
Let me explain to y'all. So, we watched a video on Twitter. It cracks us up every time we watch it. Afro Man, he's a rapper. We play some old songs. I don't know if you guys have heard that. Because I got high.
Hold on.
You know what I'm saying? Afro Man, he a girl hopped on the stage while he was playing the guitar. Bro, he turned around and backhanded her. He turned around and, like, an open hand slapped her off the stage.
Like a red eye
punch slap type, one of those things. That's the song he played before she got.
You can hear the reaction of the crowd in the back, man. It gets real wild.
Oh, yeah.
That was a slap.
Yeah, he turned around and got her off his stage, and we laugh at it all the time.
No, you know, the crazy part though is that
turn it off.
She hit her head though.
He really whooped her. Like, it was like, a bad right thing. So you know what I'm saying? I asked, you know what I'm saying?
What song was he?
Is that okay? You know what I'm saying? Things like that. And then another case that I read like a couple days ago was about Kevin Gates. I know y'all. I don't know if most people are aware, but he's the guy who I don't get tired. You know what I'm saying? He's the one who started that little saying that I don't get tired. I don't know if you hear people saying that, but two girls came on his stage and he
punched them.
Allegedly beat them up.
No, he beat them up. He didn't just punch him. He just
beat the girls up and continued to play his song after. Yes, he ate. He was playing his music after as if nothing happened. Like it was just a regular day. You know what I'm saying? Is that, you know what I'm saying? Wow. So it's like, that's what you ask yourself. Like, if somebody can do that so, you know, nonchalantly, where they could just beat a girl up and turn around, do they do that regularly, or is it okay? Like, how do y'all feel about stuff like that? A man hitting a woman, you know what I'm saying? So that's the type of things I've seen. And then another thing that happened over the weekend here at Heidelberg, there was a fight at Madison's between a guy and a female.
Where do you know
that? I take partial blame for that.
Yes.
Yeah, I hear about stuff like this and it's funny to me. I'm sorry, it must maybe not be funny because some girl shouldn't be.
He had the devil springs in him though, and that brings out the devil in him.
Yeah, probably. Yes, but you know what I'm saying? There was a guy outside here in Tiffin, and he got into a scuffle with the female. As I hear, he punched her in the eye and blacked her eye or something like that. I'm not sure.
Or open is what I heard.
Wow. Yeah, there's a lot of rumors going around, but I'm not sure exactly what happened. But, you know, I heard he blacked her eye or something, and he went to jail for it for a day or something. I bonded out. I'm not sure exactly what all happened with that, but yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's even close. That's not just a superstar on stage.
That's locally.
You know, that's right here. You know what I'm saying? So you know what I'm saying? So that's funny, you know what I'm saying? Okay. Things that I see. So I want to ask, you know what I'm saying? We're going to go around the room.
And
we're going to start with Juice. I'm going to ask you, like, would you ever hit a female?
That's weird. But all right, so I'm gonna explain myself on the whole topic like this. I'm going to pair everything. All right, so, I mean, in terms of defending myself, against, like, say, like, a female was trying to attack me, like, you know, just trying to start something with me, like, on some, like, you know, she wanted to fight me. I definitely believe in defending myself. I'll never let, you know, anybody just put their hands on me, regardless of.
You're a woman beater.
Regardless
of. Wow. Here we go.
So, I mean, yeah, I don't believe it. Nobody's going to put their hands on me, regardless if you're a male or a female. That's just flat out. But what I'm saying is, I'm not going anywhere. You know, I'm but at the same time, you know, I'm not promoting domestic violence. Like, I don't, you know, punch girls just because I feel like it on some, like, you know, it's just
some Afro type.
Yeah, on some, like, you.
I'm not going anywhere, huh?
On some, like, yeah, on some, like, you're not leaving me. On some.
No, I mean on some, I'm not moving, so if you think that you can beat me up, just try again.
Wow.
Really? What are you talking about?
She's on his back. Is there anything you have to say to her?
Tell me what you're talking about.
She is upset.
I was telling her. Past experiences.
I wouldn't recommend it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't recommend it.
Yeah, I wouldn't recommend anybody putting their hands on me.
I'm not going anywhere.
Wow. So, well, let me ask.
That's on there. But yeah, I mean, like I was saying, at the same time, I don't believe that I don't believe in, you know, just hitting women just because. Like, I'm not saying go out there and punch girls just because you feel like it, on some, like, you get home regularly and she didn't make you food, so you whoop on her. I'm not saying any of that. Or, you know, I ain't, like, Ray Rice incident, you know, all that. Like, I'm not condoning any of that.
Not even as far as domestic violence. I want to know, like, if a random girl on the street was, like, talking stuff to you, you know what I'm saying? You know, would you fight her?
Like I said, she's going to have to put her hands
does
on
does it
me.
Matter the stature of this girl?
No,
we'll get to that later. That's another part of it. That's like a subtopic.
Okay, well, is another subtopic like, is like a push or like an actual like, if she gets
mad at you, punch? If she pushed you, would you ever see her as a fighter? Who would you
like, do? I think pushing and punching are two different things, definitely.
They are, man, but.
Would you react the same way?
She's not going to put her hands on me.
So if she pushes you, then...
So if she pushes you, then...
I'm not saying she pushes me and I'm a swing, but I'm saying, like...
What would you do to a push? Answer that.
Yeah. I'm curious.
You're taking a conservative role. I want you to tell me what you would do if she came, put her hands on you, push you back up.
Yeah. I'm like, grabbing her. I'm like, what are you doing? Like, don't touch me.
Even a, like, don't a bigger touch woman, like, someone, would you still try to wrestle her around, like, a bigger woman?
If she pushes me?
Yeah.
I'm restraining her, but I'm like, she's not
gonna
touch
me. Even
if we talk about somebody in like bigger stature, we gonna hold that for later on in the show because that's a different story.
Big, what's okay. that?
That's a different story. We got Pastor Janessa. So, if you were to like, you know what I'm saying, in the case of you wanting to fight a guy, I don't know if it's ever happened. Have you ever got to fight with a guy before?
No.
Okay, so in the case of you like getting angry and like hitting a guy, do you expect him to hit you back, or do you just expect you to just like wail on him?
Get your anger out.
And you know what I'm saying, just let it out, and him to not touch you, or him, for him to just restrain you, or something.
I wouldn't expect like a punch back. I wouldn't even like really expect anything, but I could see like a restrain kind of thing, like how Chris is saying, like, what are you doing? Like, you need to calm down.
Don't touch me.
But that's the only thing is if I was a dude, I couldn't do it.
After you go out of Rome,
you couldn't do what?
If a girl punched me in my face, it'd be over for her. If you were a guy, you would
have to fight back. But you being a girl, you just want to restrain.
Yeah.
I understand.
The double standard is crazy.
The double standard is crazy.
It really is. I mean, I don't know. Honestly, I guess I don't know how you guys do it.
So if you sit up here welding on the boy.
But I wouldn't. But then again, me as a girl, I wouldn't punch a dude in the face, though.
But I'm saying if you sit up here. Okay, Janessa. How much do you bench? You.
155.
Okay. So let's just say, you know, you're on the stronger side, on the female side.
Yes.
So what if you're wailing on this dude? Like, you think, you know, you think you're...
Sweetest taboo.
Yeah, if you sit up here and you literally, like, wailing on him, I'm talking about, like, you not hitting him in the body, like, I'm talking about you hitting him in the jaw, you rocking him for real. Like, he's stumbling. Would it ever cross your mind like, oh yeah, would it cross your mind that, okay, because you up here whooping them and you know you whooping them, does it cross your mind like, oh well, I think I'm about to get punched?
That's the thing though, man. I think it's like a lot of the heat. It's like heat of the moment most of the time. Like,
yeah.
I'm always thinking like, all right, where am I gonna hit him now?
Okay, put like this. So if we all on the outside looking in. And we watching this Janessa fight or whatever, and Janessa's well-known dude, whoever it is, it doesn't matter, she's well-known. Do we think that dude is going to punch her?
I think it honestly
me listening and watching and making sure that I'm serious.
I mean, literally.
All right, man, let me check out.
Dude. I think it also kind of depends on like values for real for a dude, because I know like a lot of dudes who are strictly like, I will not hit a woman at all. Well, they'll just do like a restraining type of thing, but
so we just don't know.
But yeah, like Randy said, you really don't know. It's a heat of the moment type thing.
You might get punched, you might not, man.
I mean, but I'm not one that's gonna like hit you square in the jaw, though. You know, if you hit me, like natural reaction, I'm gonna punch you as hard as I can in like your shoulder, and it's gonna sting a second. But
okay, can I go next, man?
Yeah.
Do you want to take Randy's spot, go before Randy? Is that what you want to do?
No, I'll let Randy go first.
Oh, man.
You got the views.
Oh, man, let's go. I'm more along the lines of Juice, where...
I
will say that I want
everybody
ready to
hear off my back.
We got a phone call.
Birds and the bees, what's going on?
What's
up?
Simply overpowering him, you know what I'm saying? Like, I see where you're coming from.
Wow.
Hang on. And that ain't no fair. It shouldn't be like, should have to remind a female of you a man. Of course, you gotta be smart at how you use your words first.
Okay. Yeah. That makes sense.
I don't think you should ever tell me that.
I'll take that. Right. Okay, I'll take that.
I feel that.
But like we did say, man, Timber's
going to
slow it up, man.
There are times it does go to
the moment. Like, there's nobody that's out here trying to work with a dude up top. It's always something that,
oh, no.
Alright,
thanks for calling in and give us your answer, bro.
You do better.
Alright, bro. Okay, you know what I was thinking? Can you tell? To answer your question, you asked me if I got in a fight with a dude. The answer actually would be yes, the more I thought about it. What happened? My snacks. Wow. And my laundry basket. Did you punch him? And my closet. Michael. Wow, Mike got whooped around that day. He was all of Mike's back about the snacks. No, this was
freshman year, right?
This was last year. And he was just all of my snacks, wasn't having it. I gave him multiple warnings.
Wow. I whooped him around so hard.
I can't even tell you how much strength I had that day. I was benching 155 back then.
You were upset.
At that time.
So he was all over Mike then.
Don't let him tell you differently.
Wow.
Because he did. I pushed him and he fell in my laundry basket. My laundry basket broke. I was extra salty. My snacks were saved.
Wow.
End of story.
You can validate all of your snacks.
That's, yeah. I saw silly when he called in talking about some
news.
WWE moves on everybody.
That is silly. Man.
Oh my God.
Go ahead and finish it. Let us know. Because
everybody took the wrong way when you said it.
I'm saying we just come to not expect that.
We are here, man.
Yeah. Trophy husband, don't do that.
We wasn't ready for you to be like, yeah.
What did Derek say? Apron mom, don't do that.
Young's coming soon.
Yeah, everybody
get
the young.
That's already
us
down
because
it's coming soon. The
young's
coming soon.
Everybody chill. But no, my take on it is, I'm not really out here trying to hit a woman, man. At the very most, I restrain her. That's where I agree with you.
Why do you always be crossing the mic?
Take care of my baby.
Hey, man. He do. He cuffed the mic.
Yeah, I do cuff the mic. Man.
So no matter where she hits you at or how hard she hits you,
I'm gonna show him I'm too big of a dude to be. I'm like 6'4" tall. You feel me? I'm like it's some smaller girl. I'm not no little dude. I'm not no average size guy. Laying hands on a girl is not just gonna be good. It's gonna be look. For, it's gonna be a bad scene.
Look, man, I'll take it, man.
I'll take it from you, though.
It's a bad situation.
I'll take it straight, man.
I'll take it there, I'm still gonna get looked at as the villain.
Look, man, I'll take your restraint answer.
It doesn't matter.
Restraint answer is fine. That's fine. So you're not pissed?
You know, nah, man, I just got at the very most. You know what I'm saying? She all wailing on me. Bam, bam, and bam.
I'm
full Nelson and like my man's. And I'm just like, if I ain't even full Nelson, that's reaching too. But I'm like, yo, bro, look, man, you gotta relax. You gotta relax.
That's silly, man.
Get your hands off me.
Look, man.
That's all I gotta ask for. Okay, I'm just gonna talk about it. I'll lecture her. And tell her where she went wrong.
Okay, you know.
Tell her.
Hey, man, at this moment,
this is where you messed up.
You touched me.
Wow.
You messed up.
You gotta make her even more angry at that point.
Oh, man.
That's what comes out to,
end up being like that.
Wow.
We'll talk it out.
Okay, it's my turn to talk about this.
Yeah, yours, Avery. Go ahead, let us know what you were doing in the situation.
Okay. Well, let's just start off by saying I have been in multiple situations like that. It always comes down to, you know, when I'm getting mad, you know, I always tell people, like, just, dude, just, all right, man, just get away. All right, yo, just don't touch me. Just do not touch me. But you know how females are, you know, they like to touch and get all over people and all that, man.
So what you gonna do? What you gonna do if I touch you?
Yeah, you know.
What you gonna do?
Like that. But I probably, the only time I would actually even, like, come, like, close to a blow like that is if I'm getting wailed on, I'm losing that fight, I'm getting knocked around. And my jaw's getting rocked, and I just keep falling back like Chris Paul fell this weekend.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yes,
it does. That's why I actually agree. Avery, I'd be the same way if I was a
and
dude.
I'm getting whipped around like that.
Then you would punch her.
She would have to be punched then.
She would.
Wow. She would have to be punched then.
It would turn into a full-fledged fight between you and her. Wow.
Savage man,
Avery.
Avery, I can't.
So, Avery, you're telling me that you can't just walk away?
No!
Yeah, I can walk. If the opportunity presents itself and I can walk away, I'm talking about. We're talking about, like, when, like, an instance of when you would. And I get all the instance. If I'm getting whooped on, I'm talking about, like, I'm trying to walk away and I'm getting rocked. But I'm talking about, like, a real girl know how to fight and I'm getting rocked. And I'm falling backwards. I'm getting.
Avery?
And I'm a puncher.
Avery.
I don't want to have to.
Randy's on his back. Randy's on his back. Speak your mind, man.
You mad because you turned into the chill master, man. You got a real conservative with your answers. Before in the room, we've had some heated discussions about this, and you've been real adamant about you have no problem laying hands on a female.
And I just said, if I'm getting rocked,
you better than extreme, bro. You're a big guy. I don't know a lot of dudes that can lay hands on
extreme?
You like that.
Okay, you know what? See, I wanted to wake him down. I wonder if you get your answer out, and can I go ahead and tell my story of my. Of my instance when it did happen,
you can
okay. For everybody listening, and my mom listened too because I know my mom remembers this. And mom, I remember you told me because I saw you text my phone, tell me a real man never hits a woman, by the way, and he walks away. Well, mom, I don't know what's been put into these females' formula bottles.
Wow,
it got big, it got big. Hold on, my mom was texting me. I'll tell you exactly what she said. She said, then you stop her, not ever fight her. Just not ever. Okay, well, mom, I'm glad you said that.
So never agree.
That's cool, bro. I'm still going to tell my story, and my mom protected me the whole time.
Go for it.
But I was on a bus. This one girl who was fairly big, she was one of the bigger people in school. And I'm not talking about, like, weight-wise. I'm talking about height-wise and weight-wise.
What grade was this?
This was 7th grade.
Okay.
I was on the bus. I was sitting down at the school. I was going home, and well, Janessa Scott.
Yes.
She walked up on the bus and she smacked me in the back of my head. She was the bully of the school though, so she used to do stuff like that to people. Period.
Oh yeah, no, it'd be over for her.
At this point in time, I was a lame kid. Wow. You know, I just was. On the bus, was trying to go home, yo, and she smacked me.
She smacked you for no reason?
Oh, no, it gets worse, yo. She smacked me, and I said, yo, man, just no name. So I was like, yo, no name female. Can you just chill, man? I'm, you know, I'm trying to go home, bro. I'm just trying to go home. At this point, bro.
Is that really how you took the
I don't think that's how it
happened. I don't think that's what happened.
He said that was lame.
Can I get that back to you? Okay, go ahead. Who's on me ass now?
That's not who I was when I was younger, bro. I was lame and I used to get whooped around, bro.
But even 7 days, if anybody gets slapped around,
I literally got smacked. And everybody was all laughing at me, like everybody thought it was a joke, bro. It was real embarrassing. I just was like, yo, chill. And I was like, yo, chill, man. And to be totally honest, this girl was bigger than me and I was kind of afraid of her, to be totally honest.
Wow.
That's fine.
Because this was a very big girl. So I'm like, dude, man, chill, man. And then she proceeded to keep on hitting me and smacking me and smacking me until I turned around and I stood up. I stood my ground, bro. And she got the wailing on me. Like, I'm talking about her face punching my face, bro. And I had a real bad tongue problem and something snapped inside of me. And I whooped her. And I like got to whooping her for real. Like really being bad. I'm talking about like whooped her into the seat and everything. I'm talking about like she hit the back of the bus and came back and I kept hitting her, bro. And then I'm talking about then, you know, they told my mom and then it turned down to the whole Avery hitting the girl thing and then that's when it came down to the buses have camera thing and they saw everything and it came down to a self defense and then I remember my principal, Mr. Paul G. Ward, came and he told me that there was nothing wrong with it because she kept bullying you and you couldn't told her to stop because they heard it on the camera. And she kept doing it.
So what did mom say about this specific incident?
She deserved it. She should have kept putting her hands on me. That's what my mom said. She should have kept putting her hands on me.
You gave her a warning.
Dude, I told her, bro. I gave her a warning, bro. She hit me back in my head. She kept hitting me back in my head, bro. Like, and I used to have, like, you know, like the ball fade cut joint. Oh, my I got sorry, but I turned around and then she just got to punching me in my mouth. Yeah.
Hey, but,
that's where the ass for her.
But she, I mean, which is for no reason, bro. Why did she come at you?
Because she's a bully.
That might have been the case.
She lied to
you. But from what I've seen in the schoolhouse, she used to do this to a whole lot of people. Nobody ever did anything. Like, she never got beat up because nobody ever tried her because she was huge.
That's kind of like how
so
I
nobody did anything.
You ain't have fun of her or nothing. She was just like,
no, bro, this is not. If we talk about freshman year, then I probably would deserve it because I was the flame master. Everybody got it. Everybody didn't play around with nobody because I got skinny and I was starting to get some females and I was funny now and, you know.
I was funny now.
I wasn't lame no more,
bro. But back then, I just was a nobody. And brother Dawoo wasn't on the bus either with me. You know, so that's what happened with me.
So you took the road,
huh?
You whooped your girlfriend.
Yeah.
Wow. Your girlfriend.
My girlfriend, man. If that's what you want to call her, bro. I don't know why Rainy's laughing because if we was to see her right now, she's still bigger than you. So
amen.
I'm pretty sure she'll lay hands on you. So I mean, and I'm pretty sure Kendall, do you know a girl like that will lay hands on Rainy right now?
Yes, I know.
You think Rainy's opinion will change about restraintment?
Yes,
you think, do you think Randy's opinion would change about restraint?
Yeah, I feel like he's just never been.
So listen, you think Randy's opinion would change about restraint if you met a big girl like that?
I'm talking about. I'm saying you did the right thing.
That's what I'm saying.
There's certain girls out there that because he's 6'4" and
they will try.
I know a girl right now
that's about my size and will try Randy. She won't Randy. She like the big ones, bro. And me and Kendall both know her, and we both know she's buff body for real. She will talk Randy.
That is funny.
Wow. Am I wrong?
No, you're right. There's females who like fighting guys. You know what I'm saying?
And that's just my story.
Like Randy said he doesn't know any girls who
as long as
like
you just don't touch
it.
My snacks, we just won't have any just, problems.
Yeah, was I wrong with that?
Like, if I was a dude, like, I don't even know if she would have got a warning if she would have multiple times hit me for no reason. Like, no.
So I'm asking, nobody ever goes looking for trouble with females.
Like, but I'm asking, y'all was not wrong.
No.
You weren't wrong in that situation. Some great Avery, no, you weren't wrong. But if you're a grown man now.
I gave you my example already.
What would you do?
I gave you my example already.
What would you do to her today?
I gave you my example. If I could walk away, I can. If I'm getting whooped on, then you got to get punched.
Tell the other story. Tell the other story that you told us, the current story.
Which one?
The one that just happened.
Just don't use any names. It was recent. It was real recent.
Hold on one second. Hold on one second, guys. Which one?
Whoop shaving because she was about to, she was going out.
Okay, okay, yeah, I got another. Oh, okay, I do have another example. This is actually recent, Mom. So you can hear this one. My other example when all this happened was argument got heated. It shouldn't have got heated like that. And I got came at with a knife.
Oh no! Mm-mm.
And
it would have been over for her.
But I didn't even. But that time I didn't even.
So boom, you saying on top of it?
I didn't even punch her. I'm saying this time. Like, I'm saying like she should have got punched for cutting me with a knife because then that's definitely self defense. Like she could actually cause harm.
Right.
But I didn't. I slammed her. I slammed her.
Like
pushed
her.
I'm talking about like not a push. I'm talking about I slammed her. I'm talking about I took her to the 15th. Wow.
I tackled her.
No, I'm talking about I caught her. I picked her up. I extended, so our bodies were not together, and went down.
Wow.
Because of the fact
that... I don't know, man.
Dude, because at that point, bro, like, she came to me with a knife. Like, it was already a heat situation. I'm trying to chill, left. And then went to the kitchen, got a knife, man. But it wasn't that because of the fact that...
I'm like, what you about to do with that?
That was the question.
Right.
That was the question at hand until she came at me with it.
Oh, yeah, no.
She could have been walking towards y'all.
What you. No, it wasn't. It wasn't a walk. It was a full-fledged sprint at me.
It was awesome.
Yeah.
Wow.
It was all cool.
Ninja Kamikaze, I need you now.
No. It was all cool until like she went, bro, and she tried to and she tried to give me and she missed. And she tried again in our car here, and that's when I threw it up. And that's why I like threw it up, you know, like one of the little, and then I grabbed her. So like I threw her arms up and I grabbed her and I put her down.
You would have finessed me.
I would have been what are you doing? Like,
and after that I walked away from the situation.
I couldn't have. I'm sorry.
So, legit, your house?
Grab his knife and
whooped
it.
No, I
wouldn't
have.
Like,
outside, where were you at?
My house. And then that's when I proceeded.
Strike one.
So, yeah. My home territory?
Why was she trying to do this to you in your house? Like she was just upset? Like,
because, you know, frankly, Kendall, some people are just crazy.
Wow. So, she went to your kitchen.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
No, not my kitchen. It's not my kitchen.
You went to your mom's kitchen?
It's my mommy's kitchen.
She went to your mom's kitchen.
I swear, dog.
And grabbed the knife and ran towards you savagely.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
that's,
wow.
Yeah, no.
Females are crazy,
bro. Hey.
Did she just have bitches for you?
Man. Like, honestly, man, it's like something inside of them. When you get them to that point, that boiling point, it's a trigger inside of them. Yeah. They see red.
But, okay,
they have no fear.
I had
just
that.
Just do whatever.
No, I'm not going to joke, man. I thought I actually did really good with that situation, bro.
You did.
I feel like you did. Because you did better than me. Because
you did better than
in that situation, I would have ran. Yeah.
Ran?
You ran?
Give the man the mic because this is his favorite topic. He loved it so much. He hasn't even spoke on it yet, so he just needs to.
You kind of don't hear it now.
Okay. Wait,
you
need to
shut
the phone right now. Away?
Listen to me.
No.
Okay. Listen to me and listen to my logic.
This is the man of all men.
Look, man, I've been in plenty of fights before. You know what I'm saying? And
we know.
And I just don't. You know what I'm saying? I feel like my face is precious.
He loves to fight.
My body is precious. My temple. I take care of it. I'm in the weight room. I do what I gotta do to take care of this body. You know what I'm saying? I feel like, you know what I'm saying? If I see somebody running towards me with a knife, I'm running. I don't care what gender you are. You got a knife. I don't have nothing. Some girls might, you know what I'm saying, might be able to finesse you to slice you up. What do I look like with a cut on my face? That's terrible. How could I sit in there and try and fight a female with a knife? I don't know what her intentions are with that knife. Some girls, you know what I'm saying, I feel like if she really wanted to cut Avery, she probably would have did it. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know. She tried, boy. We're gonna see her say that she
did. Did she try to like stab you or cut you? There's a difference between stabbing and cutting.
She tried to stab. I don't know. The way he pulled back, like, yeah, he pulled back like it was about to be like a.
Intent. Yeah. Intent to kill.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, me, I was like, ran the bathroom and locked the door if I couldn't get outside.
She tried something, bro.
Then you'd have been stuck there.
You could then call the police,
man. But I'm saying that.
Just like, do you have your? Yeah. What if you
look, man. Everybody making this all crazy. Everybody like, I would do this, I would do that, man. But coming out to it, you gonna just like Randy said, dude, you can't control what's gonna happen, man. Like, you, Kendall, I don't believe that you would ever ran from her. The minute she missed, you would.
If you see her going to the kitchen and all you hear is some rumbling in the drawer, and you're in the
screen and all the lights.
What are you going to try to do at that point? She's already got escalated to the point where she's ready to potentially kill you. You know what I'm saying? So, what do you do at that point? Do you try to talk it out? Or, no, do you can talk to her through the door. I'd rather run through the door. Give her some time to cool off. You know what I'm saying? Like, dude, like, chill out. You know what I'm saying? You trying to kill me. Like, this, you know what I'm saying?
Well, I'm not that serious. Well, I'm glad, Kendall.
I'm glad.
But see,
that noise in that kitchen,
bro. I'm glad. But what we're about to do is sit on here and act like Avery's the only one. So, back to the question is, at hand is, how do you feel about the subject of
his favorite topic, so
he's going to leave. Look, you thought he was going to slide. He was the only one that had spoken on it, so this is his favorite topic. He's going to leave on it. You guys are on my back. This is his favorite topic. I'm scared to do the topic. Just go, bro. Let me tell you about it. You know what I'm saying? You know, back in the sixth grade, I got into a fight with a female.
That's wrong, man.
You know what I'm saying? Sixth grade. Wow. I was on the bus, just like Avery.
Tell me what happened.
She had a neighbor. You know what I'm saying? She lived right across the street from me. You know what I'm saying? And she was, It was the only fight I ever got into with a girl. She lived right across the street from me. And, you know what I'm saying? Like, she was like, you know, I was already one of those, like, the popular guys. You know what I'm saying? I was always cool with everybody. So, we was, like, in the back of the bus, you know what I'm saying? Just... I think he's making jokes on her, man. And you know what I'm saying? I'm always the funniest one.
That's what I said.
Wow, so you know about Kendall.
He makes everybody real upset. Kendall makes everybody real mad, man. I'm telling you.
Actually, I was in the fifth grade, and she was in sixth. It's so two grades in that school. So so she was in sixth grade, because she was a year older than me. And you know what I'm saying? It was a couple of us. Everybody around my street, you know, we all ride the same bus. So we was all like... you know, kind of ranking her, you know what I'm saying? She lived across the street. It was, like, really a joke for real. But you know how people get serious and they get in their feelings, you know what I'm saying? So, she got upset, and then she's, like, was sitting across from me. She jumped out of her seat and hopped into my seat and punched me. Wow. You know what I'm saying? Think about that. Somebody jumping out of their seat and hopping in yours and punching you.
And you were cracking jokes? Wait, yeah, oh. I probably would have done the same thing.
Mid-joke, yeah, you know what I'm saying? We laughing and stuff. She jumps in and punches me. And yeah, my first thought isn't, let's restrain this woman who's on top of me. You know what I'm saying? She already got one hit off of me. Should I let her get more trying to restrain her? Or should I whoop her? So my thought was, finish her. So that's what I did.
Finish her.
I whooped her. I got her off in the seat, and I punched her. You know what I'm saying? I got back all over her. I was whooping her in the seat that she jumped on.
Go back. Hold on. Go back for me one time, right? So she swung on you first?
Yes, she jumped in my chair.
And you ducked her like a savage.
No, she got her. She jumped in my seat.
You know what I'm saying? It was unexpected. She hopped in my seat. She punched me. And that's when
you found the little...
No, I didn't know. Wow, that's Woman City. It happened. Like, I got back up, like, after she hit me, you know what I'm saying? And I proceeded to finish her.
I whipped her. You had to finish her, though. I had to finish her. She touched me. One for one. You know what I'm saying? I don't have a sister. I didn't have a girlfriend to call up. You know what I'm saying? I'm my own man. You know what I'm saying? I got a brother, but you know what I'm saying? She's already a girl. I'm a year younger than her. You know what I'm saying? She was not a big girl. She was about the same size as me. You know what I'm saying? She had to hit me. I'm going to hit her back. So that's what I did. I hit her back. And, you know, we got in trouble, kicked off the bus. They told us to go to office. But on the camera, the only thing they see is her jumping in my seat. So, of course, neither one of us got suspended. It just looked like she was the savage jumping in my seat, not just protecting myself.
Right.
Which was true. You know, we was ranking jokes on her. But why she choose me? Because I was the young guy on the bus?
Or maybe
because
I was the
baby?
You
started laughing the loudest. No, see,
it's not always about that. It's always about when they run back there and they pick the one. They know that I'm gonna have a, you know, I can.
They feel like you're not
getting over on that.
She
couldn't.
She hit me. She might. She thought I was the weakest link. Cause everybody was saying
you were. Did you or did you not admit that you were the first one to start cracking jokes?
I didn't say I was the first one to crack. Say I said that we was cracking jokes on it. Me and Boo from my
So do you think
she was the scouter? She was the scouter.
You were like the smallest out of everyone else who was cracking jokes.
She saw his power level.
Yeah, I'm always the smallest one out of my group. So, yeah, I'm the smallest one.
So you don't think if you weren't there and they were cracking jokes, she
wouldn't
have
probably chose the next in line, or she would have chose no one at all. So she came for me, and...
I don't know. All I know, where did she hit you? Is another question.
She hit him in his face.
Okay, maybe I kind of...
Are y'all cool now? Did y'all like...
Well, she moved away, but... Like, after that, I had a talk with her dad and stuff, you know what I'm saying? Came to the school, you know what I'm saying? We had a talk with the principal and her dad and I. We had a talk about what happened and how to go about the situation and that we were neighbors and that it shouldn't be like this, you know what I'm saying? And it got resolved and without anyone getting in trouble, fortunately, you know what I'm saying? But
that could have ended all.
So enough of the playing around, man. Everybody heard my story and anyone get all over me, so, you know, I'm going to ask the same question right here. So what about now? What about right now? Girl come well on you. What do you do?
I would still finish her. I would whoop her with no remorse. You know what I'm saying? I know my mom's going to be on my back.
Even if it wasn't
funny. My mom's upset. She's texting me now. I don't understand. I would still to this day with no remorse whoop her. Yes.
Even at all.
I would whoop her. I would whoop a female. If I there's occasions that I would.
So
whoop
you're her. The woman beater.
I know. I have never hit any of my girlfriends, for the record. You know what I'm saying? I've never, you know what I'm saying, treated a female wrong. I've never had been in that situation to hit a female. You know what I'm saying?
I did say she was willing.
You know what I'm saying? I haven't hit a female since her, but I'm saying I would. Yes, I would be that guy to punch a female back. Yes, I would. I would hit him back.
So, yeah.
I would have no remorse, and. You know what I'm saying? Just don't touch me. Like I said before, I have a pretty face. I feel like I'm hurting. I don't want somebody to touch me like that.
I don't want people to call in on you guys' back. For the record, you guys aren't initiating the contact.
No.
It would have to be.
No. See, I feel like I could never hit a girl first. No. That's ridiculous.
We're not talking about that. We're talking about two. Thank you, Randy. We're talking about two different things.
Yeah,
that's what I tried to, you know, clarify in the beginning. Like, it's not like we going out and just antagonizing.
Yeah.
I'm just giving out scenarios. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, these are scenarios.
It was a situation
where I would hit a girl.
No, man. Boom. Let's say I'm with.
Okay. What about the next question for everyone? Verbal abuse.
I'm trying to give a scenario.
Sorry.
So boom. I'm with my girl or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And we out of something, she's beefing with somebody, and there's some girls, like multiple,
who are trying to
beat her up. At that point, you can try and break it up, but then once you get hit too much, what is your reaction? Yeah. Like, what is it doing?
Would you defend your girlfriend?
Hold on, hold on, hold on.
I'm going to defend your girlfriend. Y'all hitting her, you know what I'm saying? Then at that point, I feel like, you know what I'm saying, I gotta step in and I gotta fight, I gotta help her, you know what I'm saying? Who wants to see that girl get beat up?
Nobody.
We talking about a girlfriend.
Hold on, I got
another good question. We talking about a girlfriend of how long?
She's my girlfriend, we've been talking, so
we talking about like 3-4 years. Is that good?
No.
Or
if she was my girlfriend for a week, I would still fight for her.
Okay. Alright, bet. So now we
have a good time. That's what it sounds like.
That's what it kind of sounds like.
Every time this girl get beat up,
he was a statue of
limitation. He would play basketball, and she would see her old rivals, and they would beat her up, and Avery would watch her eat both of the ice creams. I understand. You know what I'm saying? See, I don't know how to say that.
He would be the cameraman?
He would be the cameraman who recorded and give her tips. He would give her tips about next time, what to do, what she should do.
No, I would always help.
Yeah.
I would always help. But see, look, man, the one thing I don't want to happen, see, I always advise her, look, man, you shouldn't go in there for that action in the first place. But I always I will always, always advise her because of the fact that I don't want her fight to have to turn into my fight. You see what I'm saying? Like,
right.
What about? Because
I want because you don't want, because in the first place, you don't want a girlfriend who's always hollering and she just doesn't know when it's just not your time. Like, look, man, you'll see her later. She's with about 12 girls. It's just not her time. You know, it's not her time. Yeah.
See? You don't want to right away. Of course, you want to tell her at that point to leave. And my mom said, you should grab your girl and get out of there. It's just not always, you can't always get out of there, mom. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, some of these girls, they come up to you on some, oh yeah, what's up? I seen you at the party, blah, blah. I don't know, I used to talk to my boyfriend, blah, blah. Boom, somebody gets slapped. Another one of her friends come jump in, then what? It's four on one. You just out with your little girl. It was a bad day, you know what I'm saying? You gotta help out, you know what I'm saying? Whether you can only restrain so many females. You might be able to get two if you're a big guy, but you know what I'm saying? It's still two on one for your girl, and she's getting whooped around. At that point, you need to start slamming females.
What about, like, verbal abuse?
Right,
like,
let me finish my story before we go into that. Fine. You know what I'm saying? I got another scenario. See, one day, this was, also fifth or sixth grade. Mm-hmm. And you all remember the strawberries and stuff, the little $15 shoes.
Yeah.
Mom's went to take me to get a pair. So me and Kyle in the mall with my mom's, and there was this lady, I think they sold her at Champs or something. We was in Champs.
Stephen Berry's.
Yep. We was in the mall, Stephen Berry's. And she was arguing with the lady, and she was helping us like find the shoes. They got into an argument about what I don't know. My mom always has an attitude in the store, so it might have been her fault. But, you know what I'm saying? And this lady, she was like bigger, and she was a dyke. You know what I'm saying? Like, she was like,
why she gotta be a dyke? Why can't she just be a lesbian?
She wasn't a lesbian. There's a difference between a dyke and a lesbian. She was a dyke, like a maleish female. You know what I'm saying? Wear jeans and boxers and tennis shoes. You know what I'm saying? That's what she was with the kinky twist. You know how the kinky twist. They gotta have the kinky twist. So she was talking to my mom all crazy on some, meet me outside after, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I get off of work at 6, I see you, mom. I would have whipped her. I would have served her right then and there at her job. You know what I'm saying? If anything had popped off, she would have got whooped. And that's an occasion, you know what I'm saying? Y'all, I'm just gonna restrain her. I would have slapped her, I would have punched her for my mom's, and I would have had no remorse about it. No remorse about it at all.
Do you think your mom should have hit her?
My mom, she's way older than her. It probably wouldn't have been, no. My mom should never touch her. That's what she got two boys for. That's what I'm there for. I'm to protect her. So if that lady would have swung on my mom's, I would have whooped her.
I'm glad you said that because nobody's ever going to touch my mom.
Yeah, nobody ever.
So now no one wants to restrain the females? Y'all would actually fight back at that point?
But I told you my story with that. I told you that.
If somebody, you know what I'm saying?
I said, I don't have no problem with it at all. All
right, I just want to know because, you know what I'm saying? Everybody was restraining, but, you know what I'm saying? You got this dyke in your mom's face. She's bigger than me and my brother and my mom, and she's talking stuff to her. What do? Do you fight or do you let your mom try to handle that?
No.
Well, it's almost like, I mean, if something would start, then, like, yeah, it's like your business. But, like, if there's nothing starting, then.
Yeah, man, anybody.
Exactly. You don't, see?
There's
situations where, you know what I'm saying, where females, you know what I'm saying, they can get hit, you know what I'm saying?
My mom needs to see no action.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
So that's her time. She needs to see no action. It's my time now.
So, you know what I'm saying? There's situations where female, where you don't want your mom, you never want her to fight, but it's situations where dudes just need to actually, you know what I'm saying, physically touch girls to get them to relax. You know what I'm saying? But that's just some situations that I have encountered in my life and how I would take them, no matter how y'all feel about it.
That's so silly, man. Hey, we all gave our stories in here. We want y'all to call in with y'all's. 419-448-2200 is the phone number.
In the meantime, we're going to get a little break in, man. We need to play some music.
All right, yeah. So we about to go ahead and get a couple songs for y'all real quick. And then y'all can call in. Like I said, y'all can call in April Fool's stories. Let us know what's going on with y'all.
Let us know how y'all day
goes. Let us know how y'all feel about the situation.
How do you feel about the weather? Is it making you feel happy?
Being a female, do you expect that guy to hit you back?
Yeah, we want
you
know to what I'm saying? Respect.
Or do you know what I'm saying? Like, do you feel like he should let you punch him?
Or are you that
female? Are you that female?
Yeah, are you that female who, you know, tries who entices the fight?
Yeah, you know, man, are you that hybrid? Call
in and let us know what's going on, but we back, Birds and the Bees.
Birds and the Bees, deuces.
I couldn't ever see myself hitting a female based off of words, you know what I'm saying? People have said terrible things to me, and what? My mom always told me, sticks and stones. You feel me? Sticks and stones, man. Words have never hurt. So, that's I went by that since, you know what I'm saying? So,
you're good. I'm not good. You say that
stuff
being sticks to you.
I've been, you know, we all been having these nice conversations, man. I've been, you know, sitting back in a, you know, straight observance of things, and I've noticed that Randy's been real quiet. Randy, would you punch your dad or what?
Would I punch
your dad? Wow. Randy, you know what? I'm gonna just be honest and blunt with you, man.
Would I punch your dad?
Wow. Yeah. Are you? I'll be honest and blunt with you, man.
We're all grown men.
That girl's probably gonna call her uncle or her dad, and Randy, you know what?
Are you gonna be ready?
You're just not a baby, Randy.
We're all grown men.
He's gonna see that chest tat. He's gonna, you know, he's gonna think you're ready. You know, he's gonna think you're one of those old slaves that, you know, like to chuck the bale of hay and just nice and strong and just ready. What are you gonna do then, Randy?
We're just gonna.
Would you let? Hold on, my bad. Would you, Randy, the peacemaker? Would you let it even come down to the fact that where somebody else is being called because the girl's getting on your nerves like this much?
We try to restrain me. I'm the most chill guy there is, man. You know what I mean?
I'm not talking about restraining you. I'm not talking about that. She ain't even touch you. I'm talking about she like, all right, bet. Now I'm calling my dad. You can't touch her phone. That's not her phone. You ain't gonna do none of that. So it comes to the point where she calls somebody, and they're coming up there.
He calls Pops. This is what's gonna happen. She calls Pops. This is what's gonna happen.
You gonna talk to Pops?
I'll talk to Pops, man. I'm gonna try to lecture Pops, man. I'm gonna take his role, the role that he should play.
Listen to me. Yeah. Hey, listen to me.
Hey, you gonna let me talk?
Wow.
You gonna let me?
I'm gonna say, look, man.
But look though,
just relax. Look though, just calm down. And if he's all hyper, man, I'm gonna just have to whoop him around.
What? He's all hyper.
We're all grown men.
So what are we talking about hyper like? No.
If I'm trying to talk to him and say, look, man, it's not that big of a deal. This is what happened. Your daughter's all extra. You know what I'm saying? I just try to, like.
That just take him off even more, I feel like.
Hey, man. And then he just wants to get around. I'm trying to be the PM. I'm trying to talk to him.
Yeah.
In a civilized tone, you know what I'm saying? Civilized manner. So like, if he don't want to hear me, then we just going to have to, he's just going to have to get tossed around then.
We're all men.
We're grown men.
But there, you still got to, you know, display some caution because, you know, he might. You know, these are grown men, man. They might lose and go to the trunk, you know?
Nobody wants that, man. Like, matter of fact, I feel like there's certain rules that you should follow, especially being a grown man. You're somebody's father, you know what I'm saying? So you grew up in a different era than I did. And those are the era of hands. These are the era. This right now is the era of guns. Where kids go to their trunks. Well, so if the bad boy in his trunk, yes, he been a sucker. You feel me? That's how I feel about it.
He been a sucker.
Birds and the bees, what's going on?
Yo. Man, once you
see it, man,
ain't no talking to him, man.
And then we supposed to go ahead and
get ready to work.
Yeah. I agree, man. You know what I'm saying?
It's
about time, man. She done already brought him over. She
called
him from home.
She called him for a reason.
Man, he was probably asleep. You know, you gotta whip him.
He came off the couch, he came from work, he's upset, you know what I'm saying? He trying to work, you might as well just go ahead and work with him. You know what I'm saying? It's your best bet. I agree with you on that one.
Definitely.
And you went to that high level where she already did the testimonial or vice versa. The best thing you can do is just be like, listen, Mike, you won. I'm gonna win. No quarrel. You won. You got it. You are a woman. It's your world. It's this.
Okay. Just get up out of there as a whole. Just try to not have any problems.
Like, not like get up out of there. Like, just get the conversation. Like, there should be no rebuttals.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Alright, yeah, be like awesome, like I ain't gonna argue with you, like you got it. Like,
right.
I hear you.
Oh no, I understand that. See, but sometimes that makes females even extra. That makes them even worse when
they want you to argue with them. You're not giving them what they want.
That's when they get to call you out your name.
Oh yeah.
Look at the female thinking like that though. Once you're not saying nothing bad,
you
need
to
hire
you
at that point.
Yeah.
I agree.
That's true. I agree with you. You look at the situation differently. So, and so I like the way you think about the things, some of the things you think about on that situation.
Yeah, appreciate that, bro. It's just all about perspective. It's a different tempo. You can't just go to the putting your hands on a female or a woman that's bad. Sometimes they get worse, and you don't get nothing. You don't get no good energy. You don't get no good perspective from it either. And you don't get one, so it's a loss.
Right, no, I agree with that. Thanks for calling in.
We appreciate it, bro.
Yeah, no problem, bro. All
right. He does, man. He comes out with a different perspective.
Yeah,
he's
yeah.
Just
that's
a
good point,
peacemaker.
Though, man. Like, when
you try to resolve
what you want. She called him the peacemaker.
Yes. Any peacemaker is just going to be wrong. Almost. He's wrong.
Peacemaker, after the fact. But no, man.
Let that man take a role like that, Randy?
As the peacemaker?
Yeah.
I try to be the chill man. I try to let you know I can.
But he is right. After that point, you just can't be chill. You really can't.
He has a good point, too, though, man. Like, people, they're not going to, if you stop completely and say, hey, man, you got it. There's only some, or that person isn't going to keep going.
They'd be like stuck on stupid.
So, okay. So since we're saying this.
They're going to stop.
You know, this is a show where, you know, we have, you know, the stuff we talk about is, you know, stuff that's happened in our lives, right?
Right.
From experience. Right?
Yeah.
Okay, let me say this. Because I like what he said. I like what you're saying too, Randy. I like the whole peacemaker role, but, you know, this is the 21st century. You know, it just doesn't happen like that anymore. You know, it doesn't just dissolve like that anymore. So there has been times where I've seen in Bedford High School where somebody tried to play the chill role and walk away, and I've seen somebody get spit on. Then what?
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm going to take it there because...
That's just a whole other
I've seen a dude walk away from a girl, man. Like, look, man, you a girl. I ain't gonna do nothing to you, man.
I had a story for that.
Try to walk away and just.
Wow.
Wow, that is crazy. Man. I had a story.
Then,
he was on the same road as I. And he was never hit a woman or anything like that. And like
something changed.
That spit hit him. It's something in the chest, man.
Do you know?
No. That's right. He was at a university. He was at Akron University.
He was
Akron
man.
So
the man that plays no games.
He was at Akron University. He's a wrestler. He's all buff body. And she was all talking crazy to him one day. He was walking past. Like, I think he was telling a jokey joke. And she called him. She called him the word.
Oh, I remember this.
She called him. And the N-word.
Was she
Caucasian?
She was Caucasian.
No. This is not even the best part of the story.
She was Caucasian, man.
It's not even the best part.
Like, wow, he took it, you know what I'm saying, better than most. I'm saying he tried to walk away. He was still on the back about it, but he didn't hit her or retaliate or anything like that to a severely. But she just kept saying, N-word, you stupid, N-word, blase, blase.
Wow.
And then she spit on him.
Oh, wow. Bro, what the hell? Oh, he spit on him.
Okay, what the hell is with me?
Hey.
What's up? Hey. Oh, yeah. Hey. All right, yeah. So we going to ask you these questions. All right, first off, I want to know, would you ever hit a dude?
Me personally, no.
Okay, you wouldn't hit a guy. But, all right, if you got to the point where you did hit a guy, would you expect him, like, would you expect him to hit you back, or would you, like, you know what I'm saying, do you feel like he's, huh?
I hit him.
I hear you.
I hate it because I have a brother, like,
you
if a female can run up on my brother, she won't hit her back, like, what is?
Wow. I guess I understand.
That's her answer.
Yeah.
She says he's going to hit her back.
Yeah, wow. Well, I'm talking about for you. You right now, I'm saying, if you hit a guy, would you expect this man to hit you back, or would you expect him to, like, you know what I'm saying, like, to restrain you or just to walk away from the situation?
I feel like it's you that should have been, you should expect what's going to happen afterwards.
Prepare for the consequences.
Okay.
Be prepared for the consequences.
All right, you know what I'm saying? I want to hear that from somebody today. You know what I'm saying? I want to hear a female say that she put herself in that situation and she should know what's going to happen.
Yeah, she gotta know she just might get punched.
She gotta weigh out the consequences of making those actions. And I want to hear a female say that today.
She think about it.
And thanks for calling.
Oh, no. I got one more question.
Hey, boo.
Do you know, any one of your friends or any female that just, you know, will be ready to fight a dude at any time?
Yes.
I'm sorry, we couldn't hear you in here.
Yeah.
Okay. I just, I need somebody to solve that for Randy, because he just never met a female who's just ready to tee off on a dude, man.
All right. Well, hey, thanks for calling in. Let us know what's up. Thanks for listening, though.
Thanks, boo. All
right.
He just said with the, wow. Thanks, boo.
Thanks, boo.
Yeah, anybody say hey boo, you just need me to cuff him. Yeah, you need to make it yours. Right.
Juice, that's your girlfriend.
Yep, she needs to DM me her number right now.
Yeah, you know what that is. You got it just off top.
Yep.
Hit him with the song.
Yep.
Thanks, hey boo.
Alright, though, finish the story, though, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
man,
she kept saying it.
N-word, you stupid N-word. And that was that. And then she upped it a level when she spit on him.
That's, man, dude, like.
See, if I was like a dude, once again, it'd be over for her.
You know what's crazy, man? Like, that's more of a form of an ultimate respect.
Disrespect, yeah.
Than disrespect than somebody smacking you, bro. Like,
yeah, man,
that reminds me of New York and Pumpkin.
She crossed like two different roads.
Two different lines.
You know what I'm saying? Right there by fucking hair and spitting on you. And did he whoop her?
Yeah, he whooped her, man. He laid hands on her, man.
Good.
And
well, you know what? That's good for
the authorities got involved. And,
yeah, what was that situation like?
How did that end up?
Yeah,
it ended up being it was on her, man. She was the instigator, and it was basically like your situation. They sat them both down. Neither of them got expelled.
They shouldn't. If he did, then his
parents should have been expelled or anything like that. But they had to hash it out like grown-ups. They had to talk about it.
Right. Okay.
And that makes sense. And then they, man, she took a loss, man.
She definitely took a loss.
She's ridiculous. Wow. Well, now that's a good question. Like, you know, Juice, if a female spit on you, how would you react to that? Would you fight her because of that, or would you, you know what I'm saying, take a passive role on some, you know, chill?
See, because this changes everybody's perspective.
It do, though. It's so crazy. I really don't know, man. Like, that's something that would actually have to happen to me in order to be reacting.
That's not verbal.
That's not common at all.
That's not verbal abuse. You said we wouldn't react to that. It's not physical. It's just.
Right. That's not common at all. Like, that's not. Like, I just. Ooh.
I couldn't do it. There's no way.
No. See, my sweet Janessa, man.
I'm saying, if I was a girl,
if you was a dude, if a dude spit on you,
you know, we're flipping everything here.
I try my best to just whoop him.
Now you're taking both shots now. Because when you said you're taking both shots.
That's a whole other disrespect type nonsense. Yeah, and I just might have to try my best.
Because of here, man, Janessa, what you in here for, man? Because we're not in here to a female.
That's fine. If I was a female, it might, hopefully I just, you feel like I did Mike.
Yeah, you got to flip it.
That's how I hope I would do.
You know the females understand.
Okay, man.
Just
whoop
him like I did Mike.
We understand that, man. We didn't, Flip the perspective a little bit, man. We didn't try a little bit of people. Well, we do have Wordplay Wednesday coming up, but we about to play a couple old school songs for a little bit.
Hold on, before we get to old school, like, you didn't tell us how you feel, though. If a female spit on you,
there's no question
you're whooping her?
Yeah, not nothing. She's getting whooped, dude. I'm talking about, like, to the every amount of. Until I'm tired.
I'm not holding back.
Until I'm tired.
Wow. Randy, what about you? I don't think you've told us.
I haven't told you, man.
Spit on you, what happens then at that point?
It's a tough call, man. I just probably see red, man. I can't call it right now.
I can't either, man. Like, I'm saying, like, from what I believe I would do, like, I'm saying, because none of us actually know, because we've never been in that situation.
That's not common.
That's crazy. Yeah. That's different.
Exactly.
She a good one.
Can you
help? You a good one.
Me? Yeah, you're good when you walk away from
who? See, me, I'm going to say here, right now, I would say that I wouldn't hit her. You know what I'm saying? I feel like...
Oh, change it up on everybody.
I ain't changing up. She just didn't touch me. You know what I'm saying?
No, I'm saying.
But I feel like I would have to be in a situation again, like you said. But I feel like, you know what I'm saying? If she spit on me, I would just be on some, like, all right, man. You know what I'm saying? So, like, brush out, like, okay, you know what I'm saying? If she actually gets my face, you know what I'm saying? So you have to, like, actually.
But you know what I'm saying, though? I've seen somebody get spit on, and it's not about the initial spit. It's about what happens before that. So I'm talking about this one. You know, like, deep down from their soul.
And then you gotta think about
movies on.
And then you gotta think about, though, you know what I'm saying? People react differently when a crowd's around. You know what I'm saying? Like, if he's just doing
a girl. I bet you 9 out of 10 she wouldn't do it if it wasn't nobody else around.
It's gonna be a crowd.
Yeah, you know, it has to be.
Because
I'm just putting it past these people.
I said 9 times out of 10. I didn't say 10 times out of 10.
I'll put it past no people.
But I'm saying, like, if we was just by ourselves, I probably wouldn't hear. You know what I'm saying?
But I'm saying,
I probably guarantee that I wouldn't hear if we was by ourselves. I just, like, you know what I'm saying? I'd probably try to leave.
But here's what I'm saying, bro. Knowing you, I look crowd round, boom. So you gonna hit her with, you know, something she didn't expect. You was probably gonna wait for her to finish her statement and yell and all that. You like, you done? Boom. And this is why, when you hit it with something like that and you try to walk away from the situation and she hops up a little bit in front of a crowd.
In front of a crowd.
Nobody knows what they're gonna do, man.
That's when it's worse, you know what I'm saying? Because people are there laughing at you. And again, people act different when they're embarrassed, you know what I'm saying?
Hold on. Dang, everybody, should I just call you on mics?
I don't know. Maybe we should just let Janessa talk in the background.
See, but what I'm saying is,
all I said was, I don't think we should have a break and go straight into Wordplay Wednesday. Get off my back.
Next, Janessa, unless you got some bars to give us,
I just know other people.
We got all the US schools. We're not getting on a boot right now. Somebody come for a mic. All right,
out here.
Real quick break, y'all.
Your mic's off.
Your mic's off. We haven't been talking about it, so we had to cut the mic off.
So what I'm saying is, there's like different levels of them. So first, she's going to, you know, like him or her, like from the soul, and that's going to offend you. And then the actual spit itself is going to offend you. Then the people around you is going to offend you. Then you got to wipe it off and feel the spit on your fingers. It's going to offend you too.
Wow. Yeah, it just sounds terrible, but still, I feel like I wouldn't know. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying.
I ran through my head, bro, and I can just feel the coldness of it.
No, you tripping on me.
The phlegm, bro. Oh, my God. I've seen it happen, bro. I've seen it, man.
All right, but I give my opinion on it. I feel like I wouldn't, you know what I'm saying? But we're going to go ahead and get to some of this music before Wordplay Wednesday. If y'all got some bars, call in, 419-458.
Everybody talking about some, we ain't going to have enough time. Y'all better have them bars, I know that.
Hey, we got time, cuz.
Yeah.
Don't even worry about it. We're going to go ahead and drop some of these bangers, though. Old school, got some new stuff. Thanks, Robin. Turn up, sign
us up.
Randy, yo. Make sure y'all type this number real quick. 419-448-2200. All right, yo. Version B. We'll be right back.
That's all right, Randy.
Noetta, hi. Yeah.
Man, they just want me to keep cutting off my camera, man.
Everybody all excited.
Let's not talk around somebody right now. Let's get it going.
Early side.
Should we let the... Doesn't matter. It don't matter.
Nah, we should go a little bit. Somebody call, just pick up the phone, hold it. And then we can let them go after.
All right, dude. We're going to rock out first, man.
All right, man, I'll go, because everybody's all pinned around.
Everybody's all chilling.
Wow. Like, wow.
Yeah, bro. Okay, I wrote a little poem earlier, and this is called An Ode to My Father. My father, the man of great stature, of who I can say I truly looked up to. I look in the mirror and see a younger you. I'll never forget the lessons you taught me, which one was better. Oh, hold on. I know which one was better. What about the one when me and old boy fought, or when I dropped that ball, could have caught, and you told me to get over and catch the next one? Or remember the time I made the All-Star game and dedicated the game to you? Or when I hit my first home run and you were who I ran over and gave the ball to? One day I'll pay you back for everything you've done. But when it comes to my memory, you just weren't there at all, were you? You're like a fog from my memory, and it just starts to clear, and my mom comes to my mind. She's the one who taught me how to fight, to not fear the weird sounds at night, to live my life. I guess this is an ode to my father. I was looking in the wrong place, and I got it wrong. Different gender, different face. Well, that was mine, man.
Turn up then.
Let's go.
Turn up, man.
Different gender, different face.
When I said different gender, different race, man, I'm talking about my mom, man.
Wow.
That was the one for all y'all out there who No mom raised him by himself, man. Did everything, man.
Wow.
Yeah, pops up there. All the memories I talked about was actually true in that poem. I did run up. I did give my first home run ball to my mom. My mom was at my first All-Star game. My mom was there with everything, man. So, you know, the memories are true, man.
We got a call in. Yeah, my mom said she liked it. It was nice.
Turn up.
Birds and the Bees, what's going on?
It's here.
Indeed it is.
I bet.
Talking, let's go.
What?
Just don't
He's
have
saying
time.
It's your turn.
All right. On you, man.
Keep it rolling.
Give me a second.
No, you don't have a second.
All right.
Why you relax? Let me find it, man. I lost my stance.
Oh, bro. My God. Juice, you want to go?
Juice can't go real quick. Go ahead.
No, mine's long, bro. Go ahead.
All right. Kendall, you want to go?
No, man. I'm all waiting for Juice to go.
Wow, yo.
Ooh, y'all, man, look.
Dude, just drop it real quick, bro. Randy didn't, I didn't know he was doing all
Randy's playing around.
Randy already showed me his, man. I know where his is.
Dude, he got a notepad full, bro. He really has a notepad full, bro.
He's still like, know where his is, man. I'm
trying to find it, yo. Give me 1 second.
Dude, just drop yours, bro.
No, I'm telling you.
Dude, just go now, bro. Just go. Do y'all even know what time it is? It's 9:59.
All right, I got it. Everybody relax. Another game. See, I one-handed pigskin. Touchdown in my city, I bring home the bacon. I get big-time checks, best believe I'm next. Bet you bubble for a screen, watch your homeboy whip. Now you screaming on the ground, man, your homeboy's sick. Mom's waiting by the phone like a first-round pick. Congratulations.
Told you. Ooh. Ooh, it was nice for a
ball.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay, all right. See you. The four ball, man. That's what's up.
Man, just for the day, man.
He said congratulations.
Let's get it. I got something soft, too. Yeah, let's get it. Oh, is it my turn?
Yeah,
you said you got
all right,
it.
Man.
Oh, you want your mic? Oh, my phone? What you want?
He wants you to visit.
Oh, you want me to record it?
Yeah, I want to, you know what I'm saying? I like to see it.
You ready for that Twitter today?
I don't know about all that. I just like to see
you want me
myself,
to, you
know what I'm saying?
You want a Snapchat or you want to
video? We all extended. Yeah, as y'all can see, man, it's 10 o'clock. We extended for y'all today, 10:01. Know what I mean? Call in with your boys. Don't even play around.
All right. I got a little short something, too. You know what I'm saying? I ain't really finished it. Just dropped it. Just made it last night, though. I was just bored chilling. Alright. My young book told me switch up the flow. It's getting too old. Now watch a savage switch up the flow, but stick to the code. Just watch a chick just choke on the choke. He getting so bold. Kinda like the black on your mode. I've been here. I'm about to up the cape on your chick. Have no fear. I might have killed a couple of you bros. Just two tears. Trying to reach a level of kills a few years. Minimum. I heard your pockets deep in the drought, so wet them up. And I know your dick is just dry as some eczema. And I peep you stressing and blowing her message up. And I better kill you. That bitch will be blessing her. Turn up. Hey.
Hey!
Oh,
nasty.
Hey!
Oh, wow!
You know what I'm saying? Oh, bro! I just savage bars.
Hey, savage bars, man. Hey!
Oh, bro!
It's all good. I ain't tripping.
No,
man.
I never.
He came with it,
Bishop. She's going crazy. She thought I said
he came with it. Man.
I didn't. I said no profanity. You get your hands off me.
Hey, it's all good.
It's all good. He just said Bishop. I said Bishop.
Hey, man, it's all good, man. Let me go ahead and step to this mic, man. I got a little story for y'all.
Tell me the story.
It's Juice Man coming finna kick it on some other ish. Georgia bread, so I gotta spit it on some southern ish. Pulling up, about to come and kick it with my partners is, but let me tell you about this little chick I was messing with. Now, shawty fine, she was cold as hell. 5'2", light skin, blue paint on the nails. Walked up to her in the lot, introducing myself and said I was scoping from afar. She said, yeah, I can tell. So, well, me and you, we gonna ride or what? She looking y'all up and down since she knew what was up. She said, yeah, I'm feeling you, so let me hop in your whip, pop in, pulled off the lot, and we took us a trip about 9 o'clock. It was time to slow it down, pulled up to a crib where you know what's going down. Got the kissing on my neck while I'm rubbing on the thighs. Then she looked up at me with them hazel brown eyes and said, so what we gonna do? I lay her down on the bed and she already knew. About two or three times, yeah, I had to knock it out. Then around 3 o'clock, grabbed my keys and dipped out.
Wow. Hey,
everybody turned up today, man.
Is it time for you to talk about sex, Juice?
Wow.
Hey,
hey,
that's all I did.
Yeah, everybody, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Everybody's all about that.
I followed Swoop with Kendall, so that's all I had to do.
So next time, we just want to have workplace about sex, then?
Wow. I don't want to do it, because everybody looked at me crazy when I said the D word. I guess I'm not allowed to say penis, but you know what I'm saying? I'm just going to...
Penis is medically correct. So technically, yeah you're fine saying penis.
I guess the D word. I guess the D word.
Just
a little. I guess you can't say D word. I don't want to say D-I-C-K. You know, I wasn't aware. Hey, but we all go ahead and drop some bangers for y'all to get up out of here. Thanks for listening in and calling in for everybody who did. See y'all Monday.
We appreciate it. Birds and the bees, we out of here.